Let's start with the medical cannabis. This has been an issue for a couple of years. Arkansas just passed. Let's start with you, Mark. Your thoughts on it?
Right. It has been before us for the last number of years. For me, it's going to have to be the devil's in the details. It's going to have to be written pretty strict. There is evidence that it works in some cases.
Right.
But I just got back from an educational conference in Colorado, and they have gone all the way with recreational.
Right.
And that is a fear of mine that we keep going down that road. They've got big issues out there. There is as much illegal selling of medical marijuana or marijuana in Colorado as there is legal.
They also have the tax dollars,
right.
Though. Does that sway you at all?
Not if you had to spend more tax dollars because of problems it brings, too. But back to the medical, yeah, I'm very open to listening to it, but the legislation would need to be drawn pretty tightly for me.
Senator, what about it? Is medical the way to go with this? Is now the time to do this in the state of Tennessee?
I think we're in prime time to do it. I think medical marijuana has its place, but it will take a lot of details. As Rep White has said, there's going to be a lot of regulation that's necessary for us to do it effectively and to do it the right way.
Do you also share the concerns about the slippery slope?
I really don't. I don't. I believe that we have more of a slippery slope when we don't have medical marijuana.
I want to keep things moving here. Also want to talk about another topic that affects so many parents and students right here in Shelby County and statewide, the future of Tea and Ready testing. Mm-hmm. Shelby County Schools has urged the Department of Education to say, let's eliminate it. Does that make sense, Senator? Let's start with you on this one. Is it now time to get rid of Tea and Ready?
I think we have the opportunity to evaluate some alternatives to Tea and Ready. Of course, our priority is to make sure that our students are prepared to succeed when they leave our school system, but we have to do a better job of aligning what we are testing them on with what they're being taught, and also how we're evaluating our teachers as it relates to Tea and Ready.
Well, continue to look at it, but having sat on the subcommittee of education for the past 6 years, Tea and Ready is working. We are the fastest improving students in the nation in education right now. We have a long ways to go, so I think we need to continue to look at it. It's really the administration of Tennessee Ready that's gotten us in trouble. That's the online part that's gone down.
Yeah.
The Tea and Ready test itself has worked fine, and most teachers and superintendents that tell me they're pleased with it.
So if we can get the technicalities and the glitches
right.
Fixed, we might be okay. Overall in education, newly elected Governor Bill Lee, big on school choices, hugely controversial during the election. Mm-hmm. You have worked on education for so long. Let's start with you on that. Where do you see we're going with regard to that?
That's been a challenge for us, the voucher bill that Governor-elect Bill Lee is talking about. It's been a challenge, and there's a lot of, there again, a lot of details in that. I've always been supportive of parental choice, but we have put so much accountability on our public school teachers that I really had to look at where we go with a voucher system.
Okay.
Senator?
I know Governor-elect Lee is very much a proponent of vouchers, but I think we need to focus on finding ways to fund our public school system and not take away funding that they so desperately need.
Or at least make sure that everyone is on the same level playing field. I mean, it couldn't possibly be fair to give one entity a lower standard.
Let's also talk about funding the TBI, especially when it comes to looking into police-involved shootings. Should the money be there for them? Because we've heard so much in 2018 and the year before about there being a manpower issue, especially when it comes to making sure there's enough money to investigate situations like that here in Memphis and Shelby County. What do you think?
Right. I would be in favor of providing them more money. I've talked to them, and they have no issue with being involved in local police shootings, but they don't have the resources or the money to do so. So that's the issue.
Do you feel like it should be funded so that
it's
they do?
It's very much necessary.
All right, so one priority that you have that we haven't touched on, let's start with you, Katrina.
I think you'll see a lot that has to do with criminal justice reform this session. We need to look at ways to rehabilitate those who are incarcerated, but also to look at sentencing reform, especially for our juveniles. I've been trying to urge Governor Bill Haslam, as he's outgoing, to grant clemency to Centoria Brown.
Mm-hmm.
And that is pretty much synonymous with how I feel about juvenile sentencing. So we need to make sure that we are prioritizing what we're doing with our kids who are in our system and how they're sentenced when they, come about issues like this. Also, you're going to see, of course, healthcare push.
Mm.
We have an opportunity now because we have so many new members. I think you all have almost, 30 new members in the House?
Mm-hmm.
So there's an opportunity for us to find somewhere to work together. so that we can help the 450,000 Tennesseans who are not insured.
Sure. Representative White.
Excellent points. But my focus will continue to be on education. We need to keep working on that, because that's how we get economic development. We have to have a skilled workforce.
Very quickly here, speaking of economic development, a lot of people are kind of pushing for sports betting on historic Beale Street. We know sports betting has come to a lot of places recently.
Right in our backyard.
Right down in Tunica, especially. Is now the time for sports betting on Beale?
It seems like it's got a lot of momentum. As far as I'm concerned, it's another one of those legislations that's going to be written very, very tightly, not wide open, because a lot of other issues come into play.
Could bring some problems.
Senator, last word is yours.
I actually agree. I really do. But we've seen what sports betting has done for Tunica, what it's done for now West Memphis. So I think we have an opportunity to look at it. I know Representative Staples put forth a bill this session to talk about sports betting. So we'll see what happens.
All right. Thank you very much.